Then static single assignment form is another way to do it all assignment in SSA are to variables with distinct names. Like you can see, when you write three address code, what happens? You can see here, p equal to a plus b we do. Then we use this p here in this next line, okay? And q is a new variable here. Then, as this p is already used, okay, I don't need this p anymore. I update this p here, understand? So that we can avoid creating multiple variable at the time. Okay, so we reuse this p and update the value of p by using q into d. Understand? Again, we are updating the value of this p here by doing e minus p, like we do in the efficient C programming and other programming languages, right? We keep updating the value of same variable. But what happens, this gives, if you are using it for analysis, it gives you a little confusion regarding the updates, right? When, on what line, if you are keeping updating the variables, the variable many times throughout your, code, then when you are going to analyze or searching for some, anomaly or bugs, it becomes a little bit confusing. So we go for static single assignment form also. Okay, so the compiler developer can choose this. So what happens here? It creates instance of this variable. Instead of using p everywhere, first it creates p1, that p2, p3. Okay, so it keeps the variables separately. Okay, so this is called what? Static single assignment.